I think he's faring very well, and it's, so I'm not going to join that chorus.
Okay. Beauty or brains?
Frankly, beauty.
Will you be staying with Lakas?
Just a few weeks ago, she was the senior deputy House Speaker, but she was replaced. 13 years ago, she was the 14th President of the Republic of the Philippines. I'm interviewing the former President and now Congresswoman, Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, who is in London for a Filipino event, the London Barrio Fiesta, and a high-level business meeting here at the House of Lords. She agreed to sit down for an interview for TFC News Conversations, but she declined to comment on and discuss the recent political drama and power play in Congress. I'm Rose Eclarina. This is TFC News Conversations.
I know this trip is meant for you to attend the Barrio Fiesta, yes, which is happening in Hounslow tomorrow, and you have an event tonight. Apart from that, what else are you doing in Europe?
Well, these two are my main events here in the UK, and it's a very important event because, after all, the Barrio Fiesta has been around for so long, and it's the biggest fiesta now in Europe. In Europe, I just came from Geneva. I attended the board meeting of the International Commission Against the Death Penalty, of which I'm a member of the board. And I met with the WTO and the World Health Organization and the World Economic Forum. And then from here, I will go to Vienna for the Independence Day celebrations, and then to Croatia for our 30th anniversary of diplomatic relations.
Oh, wow. Quite a busy schedule.
Well, but it's a good, manageable, very manageable.
You mentioned about going to Vienna, and I know that the ambassador there is your daughter, Ambassador Luli Arroyo. As former president, what advice do you give her, especially related to diplomatic relations?
Well, I don't really have to give her much advice because academically and professionally, she's quite well qualified to do that work. She has a master's degree from the Georgetown School of Foreign Service. And in the year 2000, in the last months of President Estrada, out of 3,000 who took the Foreign Service exams, only 3 of them passed, and she was one of them. It's just that by the time their papers reached the president's desk for signature, it was my first day of work as president. So I did not sign her papers. Mm-hmm. But now, 22 years later, I'm very thankful that President Marcos signed her ambassadorship.
Even if she did it on her own merit, you didn't sign it?
No, I didn't, because I didn't want to be accused of nepotism.
But it's meant to be that she will be a diplomat.
22 yeah. years later, here she is.
Okay. Ma'am, the president has been vocal that, because you've traveled with him in his trips abroad, and he said that you're actually the country's secret weapon. How do you comment on that, and why do you think he said that?
Well, I'm also a politician, so I'm looking at it from a politician's point of view. As a politician, I often also look for ways to give honor to political leaders. And so I think that it is his gracious way of giving me prestige, especially because I think it's because I also held the same awesome position that he holds now. But let me say, though, I have been able to observe many presidents, good presidents, and I must say that he is his own secret weapon.
What advice do you usually give the president, especially when you are traveling together?
Well, same. I don't give unsolicited advice.
These are actually not my questions, but these are coming from Filipino community leaders across the UK. Mm-hmm. From Jane Montelibano MacLeod. She's a songwriter, and She is now based in the UK from Hitchin, England. She said, if you had a chance to turn back the hands of time, what do you wish you could have done differently when you were president that could have impacted the lives of Filipinos?
Well, it's really not my my habit to look at what might have been. I feel that I did my best and followed my father's advice, which is do what is right, do your best, and God will take care of the rest. But having said that, I did do a couple of things that impacted the lives of Filipinos. Quite importantly, for example, my fiscal reforms with the centerpiece, which was IVAT, turned the economy around, so that impacts the lives of Filipinos. And we are still reaping the benefits of that up to today. The other one is about, another example would be about overseas Filipinos. It was during my administration when we passed the Overseas Voters Act. So I did do a few things that impacted on the lives of Filipinos.
Dan Rivelo, who's a businessman and he's a Londoner. Ma'am, what was it like being the senior deputy speaker? So we're talking in the past.
Any job that I've held is something important for me, so I do what I can to do justice to the job.
From Professor Rolly Buendia from Wales, United Kingdom. What measures would be taken or you can propose to ensure the Filipino-British are able to enhance and deepen their sense of nationalism, nationhood, obligations, and rights, specifically of suffrage, in spite of their twofold nationality, culture, and ways of life? So very, very apt because you passed the overseas voting.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think that the event I'm attending tomorrow, the Barrio Fiesta, is one very important way of keeping the sense of nationhood and community camaraderie among Filipinos. And I think I've noticed that here in the United Kingdom, there are a number of associations that promote community camaraderie, and that's very important too. Now, as to the suffrage, I am trying to, I have filed a bill that has been suggested by overseas Filipinos themselves. And this bill to enhance the Overseas Voting Act that I enacted before, this bill now allows overseas Filipinos to be elected to positions or be appointed to positions without renouncing their citizenship.
Okay.
Yes, yes. I hope that that will make, you know, that will add to making Filipinos more enthusiastic about the right of suffrage.
Okay. This one of mine is from Filipino Nurses Association UK. It's growing in number. Inasmuch as migration of nurses in the UK cannot be avoided nor prevented, what law, if any is existing, could be used or formulated, if there is none yet, to balance the needs of the country in maintaining the sufficient number of nurses on the one hand, and responding to the aspirations of Filipino nurses to earn more money by working in the UK as a professional nurse?
Well, if we're speaking of laws, the thing is that the market should be sending the signal by now to Filipino employers that they're not paying the nurses enough. That's why there's a migration outside. So I think that if we were to talk about laws, perhaps beginning from the government side, maybe there should be a law increasing the pay of nurses in the government.
Yeah. And this is from Councillor Raymond Padilla of Gloucester. As an ally of the president, in which area do you think he's faring well for now, and what does he need to work on?
I think he's faring very well, and it's not really, you know, as president, I know that he will never lack for people who try to give unsolicited advice, so I'm not going to join that chorus.
I'll give you two options and then let us know what you prefer. London or Vienna?
Oh, both. I love both. Each one has its own charm.
Congress or office of the president?
Well, of course, being the president is a job that is given to very few. It's an honor given to very few. So I think that I felt the honor of being president very profoundly. But on the other hand, I'm also proud of having been a congresswoman and a senator.
Yes. Beauty or brains?
Frankly, beauty.
Okay. West End or Broadway?
Oh, both. Both. I devour shows in both.
This is quite controversial. Prince Harry or Prince Andrew?
Oh, dear. Let's put it this way. I knew Prince Andrew personally, and he visited the Philippines a lot when I was president. So he's the one I know personally.
Okay. Elon Musk or Jeff Bezos?
Well, both of them are very successful people. I myself am from the generation of Bill Gates.
Okay. Okay. Who is your favorite royal?
Well, to me, Queen Elizabeth was really a great person. And imagine she ruled for and reigned for so long, and she sort of brought the UK into from the 20th century to the twenty-first century. That's a very great achievement, and we will always remember her for that.
If you were to describe the presidency in one word, what would the word be?
Honor.
One word to describe Congress.
Work.
Ma'am, panghuling tanong, will you be staying with Lakas?
Remember, we're not supposed to be talking about politics.
So no answer.
No answer.
Thank you so much for this opportunity, ma'am. Okay. It's an honor.